right, let's dive in Lego bin.
Nice. 7250 Colin Skywalker. Let's get this one fixed up.
And she's looking pretty rough. But you know what? For 18 years, that's not bad. She's okay. It's passable. It has survived most of the bucket. But we're not going to review that one. We're actually going to just replace it with a brand new one in the box.
And yeah, I know what you're thinking. I totally could have spent more money just buying replacement pieces for that original set and fixing it up. But I don't have the Recon Trooper anymore. And to be honest with you, that's a lot of time and less money. So I went ahead and did something stupid and just went and spent a lot more money and got a brand new one in a box, which, to be honest with you, isn't really in the best condition.
This thing ain't sealed, and it looks like they found it in the bottom of a shelf at a Walmart 10 years later. But hey, one man's junk is another man's treasure.
All right, let's crack this thing open.
Ooh, nice is.
And well, here we have it. Lego 7250 Clone Scout Walker. 108 pieces, one unique minifigure, $10 at launch, 2005-2006, perfect time for the Revenge of the Sith lineup, which this was included, and goes for about $33 to $80 nowadays. I probably spent about, $56 at auction for this set originally. I was not definitely going to buy it brand new. This thing is really fucking expensive. So, yeah, if I wanted to go on a cheaper route, you probably could have just priced or pieced this out and just built your own. But nah, I did not, because I'm not that smart.
All right, so this set pretty much was like a nostalgic overload for me pretty much, because I remember buying this set back in 2005, dragging my dad out to the no man's land that is Walmart after the holidays with a wad of cash in my hands that I got from Christmas. And I went to the old kiosk where they had all the Revenge of the Sith stuff, you know, when they had that huge like Darth Vader poster just there and had all the shit lined out. The thing was amazing. Anyway. Yeah, went there, went to go buy some stuff, but that shit was cleared out, obviously. It's after the holidays. And they only had a few Star Wars Lego sets there available. I picked this one up. I picked up a tank droid, the Tri-Fighter, and General Grievous's chase set, which I really didn't give a shit about at the time, but now I kind of appreciate having it in somewhere in the bin. All those sets are in the bin now, but I kept this one for good because I really like playing with it, and it was just a really good army building thing, which, by the way, this thing is a wonderful, awesome army building thing. I mean, especially back in the day, if you weren't really into army building, or if army building really was a thing for clone troopers, but this thing is pretty fucking solid. $10, you get one clone trooper and a scout walker set, which is pretty solid. And for 108 pieces, wonderful price. And, you know, I think that's really a fantastic job for an army building kit, because you get a wonderful looking walker here, especially for 2005. You get a clone trooper and you can use these and make up a whole little squadron or regiment, and I think that's just really awesome. Now, let's really just get into the set now, since we kind of got away from the nostalgic flashback that is this Clone Scout Walker. And all right, so for overall build, this thing is very bare bones, but what do you really expect for 2005 Clone Scout Walker? And that's fine. It's $10, 108 pieces, very easy build, can do it in no time, very reminiscent of early battle packs, honestly. That's what this Scout Walker kind of reminds me of, this very bare bones. Not as bare bones as those are, but very bare bones. Compared especially to the 20th anniversary Scout Walker, this thing is just the basic necessities of a Scout Walker that you could use. And that's okay, because it's $10 for 108 pieces. What really could you ask for more? So it's not gonna look entirely accurate to the actual on-screen version or in-universe version, and that's okay. And to be honest with you, if they wanted to make this more screen accurate, you would ditch the Zero, get with the Hero, and then add a dead Wookiee in there. And that's how you do it. We get better with it over time. But again, for $10, it's a great army builder, and it really does kind of capture the Kashyyyk look with it. You do have some greens, and you have the sans hand pieces in there. You have one printed piece here, which is fantastic. It's on the top, and my original one still has stood up for the test of time. It doesn't really have any chips on it, which is fantastic. This thing's been tossed in the bin for a while now, so I'm really proud of that. And yeah, that's pretty much it for it. It does have a lot of hinge plates here for the legs, and it does have a Technic piece to kind of maintain the turret on top of the legs, which is also kind of there. But really simple build, really simple and fundamental, and not bad. Like I said, can very, very, very easily be a wonderful army building piece. It does have some playability, and that is the legs, and that's pretty much it, which you can pose. So again, you have those hinge pieces right there, which give you a lot of fluid mobility in there, which is always fantastic. Other than that, there are no flick fire, no spring missiles, nothing like that of the sorts. So you're gonna have to use imagination on that. Tough shit, tough titties. That's okay. I did it for most of my life, and that's pretty much what I will do for the rest of my life with this set. So obviously it does come with a minifigure, and we're gonna take a look at that right now. And for minifigures, they keep it pretty basic, pretty simple. You get a 91st Reconnaissance Corps Trooper, which is not really, I don't know if it's accurate or not. I wonder why they decided to go with the 91st. Maybe because in the scene of this Walker's End is because they're trying to scout for Yoda's body, I believe, if I remember correctly. So maybe they probably would have put a Reconnaissance Corps, but it doesn't really make any sense because it was the 41st Corps that actually was there on Kashyyyk. And I think it would be better if we had that original 41st Corps Kashyyyk Trooper, if we could, the nice Jungle Trooper. I wish we could actually have that instead of this one. But no, you get a 91st Trooper. 91st Reconnaissance Corps Trooper, cannot fucking say that name. And it comes in the classic Phase 2 LEGO Trooper, which I'm, you know, the older I get, the more I'm not really nostalgically okay with this. I it's a pass. We are currently living in a renaissance time of Phase 2 helmets and designs, and ever since realistically 2013, we've just seen steady improvements of this helmet type, and I'm really liking the way we're going with that. I mean, yeah, they're changing the holes and whatnot, but this original style, it just, besides the printing, I really just don't really care for it. It fits well with the original Phase 1 troopers because you do have that cut out for the eyes, obviously, so it's not going to be all black like they are now. So you will have a black head in there, which is fine with me. But yeah, it's just not doing it for me anymore. The basic printing on the back and the front, as always, no printing on the arms and that. And you get your classic megaphone blaster, which I always love and adore. So for nostalgic reasons, yeah, it's a plus. But like I said, just not really crazy about these kind of minifigures anymore, or the Phase 2 classic ones. And I don't even ask me where the original one is at. I modded that one to hell, and he's somewhere in this place. Or maybe he's covered in paint and pieces I glued onto him. But yeah, that's really what you get. Kind of wish they would give you a battle droid if they could, just to spice things up a little bit. I think that probably would be the cherry on the top. But here is your 91st Reconnaissance Corps Trooper. There you go. That's a mouthful. And that pretty much wraps it all up. Thank you guys for joining with me on this wonderful trip down memory lane with 108 pieces of pure nostalgia. 7250 to Clone Scout Walker is just a nice piece of my childhood and probably of yours as well. Would I buy it again? Probably not. But would I make my own? Yes. If you have the money, I do recommend getting it for sentimental reasons. But if you don't have the money and if you just really want to build this simple design for your army and put it with your own clone troopers, then do it. Make it with your own color scheme. Just make it for yourself, because it's a very simple and wonderful build, and I think it looks fantastic. And honestly, I would love to have a nice little regiment of these myself. But that's everything I can really talk about for 7250 Clone Scout Walker. Thank you guys for watching. This has been Scott. Those were the bricks, and that was a review. Thank you for subscribers. Thank you for the support. Thank you for the comments. And hey, if there's another set that you think should be saved in the bin, if you think there's a set out there that's been collecting dust and should be a little more attention to, let me know in the comments what that set might be, and maybe we can make it happen on this show. All right, until next time. Thanks.